Good. Now hold on. Now we got a big little. Okay, so if they do switch it, you got a big little matchup. If they don't switch it, it's a layup. If this can be your shooter, okay, I've had some shooters over here. If this can be your shooter, and this person has been told, oh my gosh, she gets a shot, you're sitting down. You know what I mean? Then you are going to hug like crazy. Okay, let's see how smart we are at Kellen University. University now, not college. So we're going to run the same exact thing to the other side. Okay, so hold on a second. Think about your role. How you feeling? We good? Same exact thing. What are you doing? Yeah, you are, right? Okay, you get to score. Ready? Set. Here we go. Okay, so I want early, okay? And I will tell you that this person's job right here is really important. You will walk down and act like you're doing something. That helps a lot. And then you actually go under that screen, okay? Alright, let's go that side again. Okay, ready? Here we go. Get there. Right? Okay, missed it. Let's go again. Let's go again. Do you know a sweep was coming? You knew a sweep was coming, didn't you? Gotta hit it. Gotta hit it. Decoy over here. Decoy over here. Let's go. Okay, timing wasn't great, but we still got a semi-okay shot. Alright, so we started our practice a lot of times for our warm-up stuff, going down the mat, short course, running sets. And it'd just be like, okay, we're going down there with one, going down there with two, going down there with three. It does take some repetition to do it. I will tell you that certainly the freshman Jake all the time it was open. It's quick, it's easy, it's one or two passes. Alright, next favorite one that I have. Still box sets, and that's all I know. Okay, you are going to attack. You're the part of the rest of the right. Okay, you're coming in your dribble now. You are corner, and you are going to boost me here in the set. Okay, so hold on right here. As she crosses this free throw line extended, we've got a simple back sweep coming up here, okay? So as she comes, you come here, you're going to hug her because she's a shooter, and you're just like this, and then you're right here, and you're showing me a low right hand bounce pass right there for a leg. Okay, let's go. Are you ready? Attack. Right there. And go again one more time, ladies. Timing, running through them, talking about the little things with the set, I'm working on writing. Let's go, ladies. Ready? Get deep. Slide right down. And then, yes, that's good. And I really talked to my point guards for a lot of years about getting deep down here, doing a good one-handed bounce passer, getting deep and throwing this pass right down here. Low bounce pass there to your left hand. One more time. We didn't run it to the left a lot because I'm going to get quicker, and it's hard to make that left hand one pass. Here we go. Come hard. Right there. Okay, good. All right. Now, let's go after that one again. Second part now, okay? Not open there. You are cornered. You are pin screening. You are curling. You are popping for three. Okay, so if we throw it to you because she's not open, we throw it to you right here after that screen, then you're just going to lay up when you weren't open somehow. Throw it here. Now, right now, here we go. Okay, pin screen, come down, and curl tight. We're looking for that layup right there, and then you are popping for an open three right out here. Right to this area, that second part. Okay, this is the second part. I want you to try to get open still, and then pop. Absolutely. Okay, get deep on the right, wait until she crosses the line extended. Go! Okay, not open, wait. Curl. Nice. Good. Okay, that's second part to that. Alright, draw on the machine as well. Let's go back to the first thing we did. Remember the first thing we did? Okay, let's show the second part. Let's get you away first. You ready? Can you do it? Okay, so here we go. Let's go back up. Come again. The first play we ran. The very first play we were doing. So you're popping. You're like a screener, you're a screener, right? Here we go, bucket.
Yep.
Okay, good. Didn't love the timing, okay? And I need you to walk away. Walk away and then dive. And then I need you to not throw it to her because I want to show the second part. Here we go. That's better timing. Okay, stop. So your second part after entry here, okay? So you enter there, you got one shooting the leg. Okay, is your screening her right here. So a lot of times these two right here would get confused. They both go there, they both go here. Okay, and this is my shooter. Remember, this is the shooter that we started with. You are screening down for her and she's just topping the key right here. Okay, right here. That second part of that set. Okay, let's do that one in the second part. Go.
Yeah.
Not open. Okay, good. All right, that's the second part of the first one, and I showed you the second part of the second one. I have control of so many situations, and we would do it out of main free throws. I just feel like we're going to, and they would sprint down and really not even a line and just run it. I guess my thought is, you can control who gets it, where they get it, and it's two passes. I don't know why you wouldn't put something in like that. All right, let's do some zone. Any questions on the man ones first? Any on the man ones? All right, let's do the zone one. Can I get a 2-3 zone? 2-3 zone. All right, let's go one more up here. So you're up there, you are up there. You're perfectly here. All right, thought on zone sets. All right, so we have what we call an automatic zone set. Okay, so early in my career, when someone would flash zone at me, we would have that one really bad trip. Really bad trip. Next trip, we're like, oh, they're zoned now. Okay, now we can run something. And then by the third trip, we kind of get it. I don't know what your first trip against zone looks like. Okay, but if your first trip against zone is not great, just put it in an automatic zone set. Meaning it was a no call. Okay, we just knew. One time we came down, we're like, oh, out of timeout, they went zone. And we knew we were going to score a lot of times, and we just back up. No one would say anything. Then we would just get into the alignment of my favorite zone set for that year, and we would run. I think it takes minimal practice time. It makes you look really smart if they flash zoning you one time and you score against it right away, okay, with a favorite zone set. And if you don't want them to be in zone, it's so weird about zone. If someone scores against zone, what do we all do? We like, back to man. Okay, not working. Someone scores against man, we play man harder, you know. Right? It's weird. So if they go zone, and if you don't want them in zone, they go zone and you run this and you score, there's a chance that coach can be like, oh, that zone's all this stuff. Yeah, man. So we just call it automatic zone because we would practice it sometimes. I'd flash double them and we just do it. All right, so here's one of our zone sets. We're going to get a corner three. Can you shoot? Outstanding. That's what sometimes. How about at 8:40 in the morning in front of 300 coaches? Okay, all right. No pressure. All right, so this is written out on the sheet, so we're going to enter there. All right, you are going block, you are going elbow. All right, it would be great if you just took about one dribble down to the right to start this. Okay, right about here is good. Okay, so like here, you're going to get a corner three out of this, all right? You come back and catch right here. Sorry for finding anybody you, I just haven't met you yet. All right, so now all of this is going to happen. You're going to shoot a corner three. Who's starting here? You think, Robin? I think maybe, yeah, you can stay back in the zone. It's good. You can probably come back over here, right? You're going to do a really, really hard left. As she does that, you're going to pop to about where she is, okay? And as she goes over there, I know what you're going to do, and this is who we're screening, okay? She's going to be like this. I got, okay? Pass is going there to the big right there, and you are turning right here on the outside girl. Okay, whoever, if she's down here, I don't care. If she's out here, I really don't care. You do that screen. It would be great if you didn't make it really obvious until later that you're doing it. You know, if you stand and start bumping, she's like, I'm getting screened. I'm going to have natural reactions to fight through that screen. Okay, you ready? Let's see it. Go. Hard, pop.
Yeah.
Right there. That's gutsy. Little things again that need to be sold for the set. This is certainly one of our automatic zone sets. We usually have, let's say, 7 or 8 zone sets that got us really good looks. This could be one of them. Also, very obviously, very clearly, can you run to the other side? Okay, how do you feel about moving the other side? Are you not sure? Let's do it one more time. Ready? Let's do it again. Right? So work for me a little bit. Okay, you got it. You got it. Swing it. Triple hard. Pop! Good and good. Okay, you better pass, and that's right. Okay, now if you watch what the other person did, can you run it left? Let's come back. Clearly, Calvin University did not see what was happening on the other side. All right, so you're good. You're going block. You are coming elbow. Okay, with me? You are just taking a dribble down, and then you're going to throw it back to the point right here, and then you shoot. There's no pressure. She switched it.
Yeah.
You notice that? Yeah, you also find that. Yeah, all right. Ready? Here we go. Good. Now, hard work. Make that zone move. Right there, pin. Good. Nice. No! That's all right. It looks really good. One more time. Give it another shot. Could be your automatic set. I like it. It's just a couple of passes. Works tremendously against the 1-2-2 as well. Go 1-2-2. Go 1-2-2 zone against and run. Even more. Okay, here we go. Let's do it. Either side. So it's one of the switches. Okay, now there's only two down there, and it's even more. Could be your automatic set. That's one option. Let me show you the other option. All right, back to a 2-3 is cool. Back to a 2-3 is cool. All right, this one requires a bunch of timing stuff. So we are going to kind of walk you through it to start. This one's written down at the bottom of your sheet, guys, and later. So we're going to dribble left. Okay, this is the cue that you are going to take off that corner, okay, and you start heading that way. All right, both bigs will drop to the lot, and you will actually start heading this way as well, okay? So you are going to end up picking the far side of the zone, that way, okay? So we always said little, big. The little is going to pick the little, okay, the outside of the zone. The big is going to pick the big, which would be the middle of the zone. You get to shoot a layup from right here, okay, you're going to be really open. We're going to stress this girl out right here with this set, okay? So she has to make a choice about, wait, I've got a person who's right behind me is open in the corner, okay, and the dribble's going to be coming hard this way, but I've also got some stuff happening back down here. So she's going to have two people to guard, which is going to be very, very hard for her. All right, so let's see if we can go slow-mo with this, okay? Ready, so we're going to go left, you're gone, okay, you're blocked. Now we're going to come right, okay, go, and right here, right there. Okay, that's the pass right there, okay? Little things about it. Chad is here with me. My son Jordan's here with me. But Chad, I don't know how many layups you made in this play in your life. He's a kicker. We didn't go through much. Open a lot. Okay, so I want you to go under. Okay, so I want you to leave early and come under. You just had to under over there. Okay, and again, timing is great. If the two of you, if this big coming from here could kind of just be sneaking this way a little bit, and you're just now running past her over here, and as you cross right there, bang, bang, okay? And then you are walking down here, kind of nothing, and you come right here, and the pass that leads through most often is like that low one-handed bounce pass, depending on how you're being guarded right there. Okay, you understand that? Okay, let's see it. Okay, not bad. So, zone, can you do a little bit more for me? I'd like you to stress her out a little bit. Yeah, and again, probably, at least how we usually got it, would be right here, and we would like to stay like right here from this angle. Quick pass right there. Okay? Right there. Good. Okay, let's go one more time. One more time. Let's get her more open. Number two. We got to bump her out a little bit. And zone, when the ball goes over, you should move with that ball. You should be waiting. She's going over there, and then you're going to turn and get hit. Here we go. Good. Okay, so that's the bottom zone. So questions on the couple of zone ones that I've shown. Okay, again, either one of those would be your automatic zone set. I think they'll both be open for you. Let's jump. I got about 8 minutes. Let's jump into another man. Maroon, you're on offense. All right, and Maroon's on offense. Guard your man. This one is not written down, so I'm faster than I thought. And actually, I kind of want some more time for the next session. I think I'll stop for like 3 or 4 minutes and walk you on if anything that gets going. So back when I played for LB, way back in the day, Coach Turner, we ran this play. I ran it a lot for a few years, kind of stopped running it. It's one of the weirder looking plays that you'll see. It doesn't totally make sense. And it's oddly open. I had two big kids back in the day. We Okay. So, last one, I'm sorry, then I'll walk through the clinic and start with another thing. All right, so we pick down, pop out. That is where we go. Pick down, pop out, exit there. All right, so here's the weird offense. You're gonna pick away between these two. So you two are on a bottom play, and you're just picking away, and hope that she's like, oh yeah, something's gonna happen, right? These two are doing the thing, so you're on offense. So where are you right now with the ball over there? Coach Krista would be like, if on a move line, or what's the terminology? I'm not sure. You guys are practicing, you did?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. So I'm the help or whatever Coach Krista, the coach of the year says, right? You're gonna be there, okay? You are going to take advantage of that, and you're gonna walk this way, just bump a little bit, and kind of act like you're asking, okay? You are going, you are on offense, right? So I'm gonna demonstrate for you. You're gonna be right here, okay? And after that catch, there, you're gonna come to that thing, you're gonna come right here, and you're gonna throw it in the air, right here, okay? If this person is a great defender, and it worked at the college level repeatedly, 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 that this person would jump in to help, and you're picking your own guy, okay? This person is going to be like, what's going on? Because you're just gonna do this spin, and you just lob it, and it's not like you go up and dunk it, you just lob it into this area. Who are you reading? You are 100% reading right here, okay? You're not reading here. She's giving this, it's gonna be very hard for her to get it, okay? Here we go. Go. Good. Good. One more time. One more time. Push your own line. Right there. Good. And you can throw it really early. You see that girl, you can throw it really early. Okay. There's a few steps. Anyone, any questions before I go up and make a turn with some of the things? Any questions or any of those steps? I'm going to take it if you want. Oh, sure. All right, I'm going to put the door right now. I'm going to demonstrate the next thing we're going to do in a minute. All right, so welcome. It seems like everyone came here. I'm really unbelievably excited to hear. So they're like 100 coaches that are repeat customers. We're just really thankful they're here. Started doing it last year. Once again, I'm Ken George, coach of FHC. Did this last year really because, I went to a lot of clinics and felt like I didn't get a lot sometimes. Like I just was like, actually, I don't know. And it was on the radio, it was the project yesterday, and I think he asked me why did people come, and I think it's because it's high school for high school. College administrators and a couple college coaches, but guys that are in the trenches, you know, we don't have the things that Coach Izzo has and some of those other coaches have available to them. So it's high school coaches talking to high school coaches. Some thoughts for you before we start. I want to thank my sponsors real quick. The score, they will meet us today at lunch. Score Restaurant Bar, Strong Black, Barbura, Irish Moving. So I got one feedback from last year that said my butt was sore at the end of the clinic. That's what they said in their email to me. So I have seat cushions for you. They are average, but they are yours if you want. There's a pile there, and there's a pile in the other gym, and maybe right now you don't need them. Maybe later you will. Again, they're okay. I just didn't want anyone to have a sore butt in my clinic. So we got those for you. You can take them. Okay, they're yours. If you want to grab one and take one, you can take it. Kristen, Irish Roofing, help me with those. Christine Doden, best realtor in Grand Rapids. Bigby, I don't think there's enough coffee, I hope. Bigby takes care of me every morning all the time. The donuts are from Sprinkles in downtown Ada. Really want to thank Mark Christer, who is taking the time out on a Sunday from Calvin University to give me his team. In the other gym in the morning, we'll have the Alabama men's varsity team and Coach Hargrave demonstrating for us, which is great. Coach Chandler from Northview, who I don't know if he's in here right now, is hosting and is also speaking. I'm really thankful. We were here very late last night. My wife Meg really does everything. Honey, not in any way. Every email you got that you thought was from me, not one time. Not one time. I have no clue. This is my deal, but everything else out there is her deal. And I think you would probably say when you register very soon after, sometimes within a minute, you have not finished your email, probably. And that's my wife, and she works really hard to make it great. I'm back here today. Peg is a rep. We'll give away some stuff at lunch today. I wanted to play that. In your bag, we've got, and this is, she's here to take pictures of all of us. Gray Transit 4 Lifeline, 002304. I know you want to stand up now. I know you know. So just in a minute, that might be up to me and go. All right. in your bag. We've got a runaway whiteboard board in there for you with a runaway whiteboard marker. We've got the schedule for the day is in there. Check that out. What else do I have in there for you? Got a notepad in there for you. The schedule is in there as well. There's also, I really like it. Last year, I just told the company, please make me a playbook. I really like the size, and it's got a lot of stuff. That is really cool. A lot of our speakers today will have handouts, not all of them, but please feel free to take notes. In terms of photo, video, whatever, do it. Do whatever you need to do. I did try to get most of my coaches, my handouts this year. If you want a video, and if you want to take pictures, do it. Toy with me, the video taking all things at some point, but I want you to pay me. You should get this. I don't know if I want to give it to everyone. You should get this stuff. You pay. So that's kind of my thought on it right now. Some other general thoughts. A lot of you are on Twitter with me. Last year, once a week during the basketball season, I did a quick 2-minute video set. I did a variety of things. At George HoopSmart on Twitter, if you want to jump on, I think I like doing it this year. I really liked it. And I also have a YouTube channel called HoopSmart Tool for Basketball Coaches. All of those videos ended up there. There are probably 40 little videos I've done on HoopSmart Tool for Basketball Coaches YouTube channel if you want to subscribe. Probably once we get going, I'll get that going again. Alright, lunch. So we'll eat in the cafeteria. People that came here last year remember what happened at lunch. And now we're double this year. First of all, we ran out of food. First, people went through the first line, oh my gosh. The piles you can take what a normal group eats and go. I told them we have 300 coaches and we have 20 demonstrators. They brought food for 400. So I think we should be fine. And if you can semi-walk fast, we've got four lines this year, but we have twice as many coaches. I think you might be a little bit late. I'm sure you weren't in a bunch of a line out there because my wife promised me no registration on. So just kind of move and take what a normal human would eat. That would help us a lot. Water, drink of water out in the hallway various times today for you. The deal is for you. I just want you to gain anything and everything you can gain. We have some incredible speakers, and I know that's why you're not for me, not literally right on my board. But you look and you see some of the people who have speakers, and they're phenomenal speakers. So I'm really excited to have you here for that. All right, so I want to, as a warm-up for these young ladies, do one of my all-time favorite drills. So now I'm going to switch to sheet number two that says shooting drills, okay? And it starts with run and gun, and run and gun is our warm-up drill. Coach Beeble, can you put 31 minutes on the clock, or 30, yeah, or if you want to do, I don't think we'll do a full 4 minutes. Let the buzzer go off on me. All right, so this is, I don't know what you do to start practice. I will tell you this was the greatest thing for me when I started practicing.